Hi everyone, in this video we'll be looking at the kinematic or suvat equations, starting with what they are and how they're used, and ending with how they can be derived. There will be two more episodes after this showing how to solve slightly more complex problems, such as calculating how long it will take for an object to catch up to a moving target, and calculating the velocity required to shoot a ball through a hoop. For now, consider this red dot as it moves from point A to B. There are five main things we can list about its motion: its overall change in position, in other words, displacement, which let's pretend is 8 meters to the right. Then there's the time it takes to travel between the two points, which is 2 seconds, the object's initial velocity, which here is 1 meter per second, its final velocity, which is 7 meters per second, and its acceleration, which is 3 meters per second per second. When writing the equations, displacement is usually denoted by the letter s, initial velocity by u, final velocity by v, acceleration by a, and time by t, and as you can see, these variables form the acronym suvat. So each of the suvat equations uses a different combination of 4 out of these 5 variables. Thus, as long as we know the values for any 3 of them, we can use the equations to calculate the unknowns. It's important to note that these equations are only applicable to objects moving with constant acceleration and in a straight line. Let's do one example. Say we're making a video game and we want our character to be able to jump a certain height. The first thing we need to do is decide which direction is positive. I'm going to say that upwards motion is positive and so downwards motion is of course negative. Thus, if we want our character to be able to jump, say, 3 meters high, then the displacement from the ground to the apex of the jump will be positive 3 meters. We also need to choose a value for the acceleration due to gravity in this imaginary game world. I'll pick 20 meters per second squared, and this is downwards, so that value will be negative. The question is now, what must the initial velocity of the character be in order to reach a height of 3 meters when jumping? Remember that we need 3 pieces of information in order to calculate the unknown, so we need to find one more known value. As it happens, we know the final velocity here, since at the very peak of the jump the character will be moving neither up nor down, and so we can say that the final velocity is 0. Now we just need to find the equation that uses the 4 variables we're interested in, which are s, u, v, and a. And as you can see, the only equation that has this combination is number 5. We're trying to find initial velocity, so let's rearrange this equation with initial velocity isolated on the left-hand side. We can then substitute in the values we know to get u squared equals 120. We then simply take the square root of both sides to get u equals about 10.95. Now that we know the initial velocity, we can make the character jump the height we wanted. So a lot of the time, it's really going to be that simple. You'll have 3 known values, and you just plug them into an equation to find the 4th. For the rest of this video, we're going to be looking at how these equations are derived. Speed is a measure of how far an object travels in a given amount of time. You're no doubt familiar with the equation speed equals distance over time. Since velocity is just speed with a direction, we change the wording to velocity equals displacement over time. And of course, if we consider that the object may be accelerating, then we must say average velocity equals displacement over time. The average of 2 numbers is just both of them added together and then divided by 2. So average velocity, or initial velocity plus final velocity over 2, is equal to displacement over time. If we substitute in our variable names, this is actually one of our kinematic equations, although it's usually rearranged by multiplying both sides by time to get it in the form displacement equals initial velocity plus final velocity over 2 multiplied by time. Acceleration is a measure of how much velocity changes over time. Since we're assuming constant acceleration, we can say that acceleration is simply equal to the change in velocity over time, which we can rewrite as acceleration equals final velocity minus initial velocity over time. If we substitute in our variable names, we have our second kinematic equation, although usually it's rearranged by multiplying both sides by time, and then adding initial velocity to both sides to get final velocity equals initial velocity plus acceleration times time. The remaining 3 equations can be derived by combining these first 2 in different ways. So, for example, we can replace the final velocity in the first equation with what we calculated final velocity to be in the second. the two u's, of course, add together to make 2u, and then if we perform the multiplication by t, we get 2ut plus at squared all over 2. Simplifying this leaves us with displacement equals initial velocity times time plus acceleration times time squared over 2. That's the third equation. Let's now rearrange the second equation to solve for initial velocity. We substitute that into the first and simplify in the same way as the previous one, this time to get displacement equals final velocity times time minus acceleration times time squared over 2. This is the fourth equation. For the final equation, we will rearrange the second equation to solve for time and plug that into the first equation. Note that the top part is a difference of squares, so when we multiply it out, we'll get s equals v squared minus u squared all over 2a. And this is usually rearranged by multiplying both sides by 2a and then adding u squared to both sides to end up with final velocity squared is equal to initial velocity squared plus 2 times acceleration times displacement, which of course is what we use to solve the jumping problem. Alright, I hope you found this video helpful. Make sure to check out the following two episodes for some more complex problems. Until then, cheers!